way I get more distance. I'm 65, been still in the 280, 270s. No effort. Never get tired. Never off balance, never forcing. Using my whole self so well. Ball just travels.
Who's that guy that's gonna catch him?
Well, one of the things they all like to ask, and I know they do it every week, why do you stop the putt so far behind the ball, and why do you stand so wide?
Well, I stand wide for better balance. I lose distance, but I don't care. But I hit it dead straight, but it gives me way better balance. But the reason why I put the club here eliminates three things. I can't pick the club up. I can't take it outside. My right shoulder is already in my turn. Look at my right shoulder already. Way on top of that foot already. And I haven't even started. Not. Look at my own head. It's way. It's never on the ball. My head itself. It's always behind. Same as Jack Nicklaus. But I put it there right from the start. I got it there right in my own setup, puts me there. With the club way back here.
Under and over, Mo. That's why he's so good. He comes in so far underneath himself, and I want him to show you. He's got a wonderful way of doing it. Show them the underneath. Right elbow.
My left arm's always way higher than my right at impact. Never this stuff. What do you want today? This. To me, that's crap. That's hitchhiking. Look at the thumbs. Hitchhiking. I want to keep my thumbs behind that ball as long as I can. Keep those thumbs back there. Not the crap stuff they want today. That's why nobody hit the ball where they're looking. It's all.
They tend to do when they come over. How do they come over?
They put their hands over here. They want to hit the ball there, and their hands are way out in the at 9. I never want to put 11 or 10 o'clock in my mind on any shot I hit. Only 12 o'clock or 1. Always. Never want that. Never. If I did that, I couldn't work under like I do so well. I believe 12 o'clock. Every shot I hit, here's 12 o'clock. This way I never go left. No indication or nothing of ever going left. But such a simple move this way. It's such a simple move. I can make it every time.
I was about lagging at Mo a little bit because he's one of probably the single most marvelous thing that Mo does. He's got this marvelous angle on the approach to the ball. He has a tremendous angle. The angle between his left arm and the shaft is huge. It's still at about 90 degrees right at that point. Then he just releases all the energy. That's one of the great things that he does, probably better than anybody. He retains the angle a long time and then he just kills it from there. Most people do what now?
Four. You say go backwards, I say they run over first base. I'll swing right over second base. Swing right over top of second base. If I'm setting at home plate. All my home runs are in center field. Never right field or left field. Every home run I hit is over the center fielder's head.
How old is that tee you got there, Mo?
7 years now, going on the eight. Still got the same one.
Oh, look at this.
Now you want to see it go 400 yards. Here's past dailies.
Oh my
God.
That's when you got great eye hand body coordination. We can hit it off there. Straight off of that. My eye hand body coordination.
Oh.
Yeah.
guarantee.
That's why the manufacturers are broke. They're all broke. They have no customers. What are you doing with all those T-shirts? You don't need all that. Hey, you only need one, sir. You don't come out here to hit a tee, you come out here to hit a golf ball. Not the tee. That's what I was taught. You come out here to hit the golf ball, so let the club get it.
Now hit it low off the tee, Mo. She does this better than anyone, than just hitting a low ball off an extremely high tee.
Nice and low into the wind. Hit it down low. Just let her run. Just let her run. Huh? Here's another low one. Keep it down nice and low into the wind.
Well, how do you keep it so low?
It's hard. That's hard. I drag my left. I really drag my left wrist. No sign of, there's no hit. It's just more of a pull thing. You're not going for distance now when you're trying to hit a low. You're going for control. Another low one. Let her run.
The other way of viewing that too is a good question and a tremendous answer. Mo sees things so beautifully in mind pictures, but keep the handle ahead of the club head. Do that again, Lang. You always keep the handle in front of the club head on low shots. And on high shots, the club head can pass the handle.
Here's a real high one now, over the Empire State Building. Way up on the 120th floor. The guy waves at him. The guy had a beer in his hand, he spilled it. You wonder what that flying object was. Another real high one.
How do you hit him high, Mom?
Hitting on my upswing now, so I wait for the correct guy. Now my right hand. Hitting it more on my upswing. Another straight line. How simple I keep it. That's what I'm trying to show you. Same move with every club. Everybody else got 13 swings, a 2-iron swing, a 6-iron swing, a 9-iron swing, a 4-wood swing, a driver swing. Driver swing, 9-iron swing. I got the same with every club. I got the same pictures in my mind. Because your mind works in pictures, not in rules. I see a picture, okay. I see the flag in the hole, it's going right in the hole.